Hey guys and dolls, it is February the 7th today, and so today along with our pot of every day, hashtag that we're doing in 2015 because sometimes you just need something to celebrate, today is Take Your Kid to the Library Day. That was one of my son's favoritestest thing of all time was going to the library. He loved it when mommy would read to him. I read to him starting when he was about 6 weeks old, and I felt like an idiot reading to a baby, but it paid off. What they say about reading to your kids really does have an effect. So if you don't have any kids anymore, take your grandkids, and if you don't have grandkids, borrow somebody's kids, but maybe get permission first, because that'd be a little bit weird. But some of his favorite books always were things like If I Ran the Circus by Dr. Seuss, The Sleep Book by Dr. Seuss, and If I Ran the Zoo by Dr. Seuss. And of course, these are, you know, the thick original ones. These were actually my books from when I was a kid, and that you can see how big they are. They're large size. And so it's funny because he would always pick a book, especially at nighttime. Nap time wasn't so much of a big deal because I read to him at nap time and at nighttime, and then during the day if he wanted me to read to him. And then, of course, when we went to the library. But it was always so funny because he would pick like a book like this after I had just said, now make it an easy book for mommy, you know, because I don't, you know, it's going to be hard for mommy to read. And so he would always pick a really difficult book. I'm trying to see if I can find a difficult page in here. Okay, let me find the zoo one, probably is better. No, the circus one. Okay, I'm having to decide while the camera's rolling. I know, wasting time, but it's funny because this is the Circus McGurkus one. Let me see if I can find him one. Oh. Yeah, okay, this one is all right. It says, and now come to this spot where the spotlight is hot, and you'll see in the spotlight a juggling jot who can juggle some stuff you might think you could not, such as 22 question marks, which is a lot. Also 44 commas and also one dot. That's the kind of a circus McGurkus I've got. And so, you know, it's tongue twisters and stuff like that. He just loved it. He thought that was hysterical. Now, along those lines, because we're doing shout outs, because it is, it's a map, and I'm putting a pin for everybody that I give a shout out for, and this shout out was sent to me by a prankster, I believe, so I thought it was fitting to do it today on Take Your Kids to the Library Day, which the library's awesome. Donate books, donate money or whatever to your local library, but this person's name, they're from, I think it's Homebush High School in New South Wales, Australia, and it's Mr. Archie, I think it's Petrie, it may be Petrie, at that school, and I'm not going to say it how it is, but he said he wanted a shout out for two people. One of them was Luciana, this is a hard name, Bernardabo is the last name. That one sounds pretty legitimate to me, but the other one is Lou Spatoli. Now, I'm not going to say it like it is, but if you phonetically write what I just said, you'll see Mr. Archie Petrie, or Petrie, is a prankster. So there's your shout out for you and the two people that are either fictional or non or a combination thereof. And you are going to get your pin on the map right now. Ready? Here we go. All right, Archie, according to my calculations, y'all are just right around, I think, just south of Newcastle, above, I think that's Wollongong. Gosh, I don't think I could live in Australia. I can't even say the names of the places. So I think y'all are about right here. I'm thinking. So I'm going to give you, if I can get it to stick. There you go, Archie, right there. Ta-da! So how was that? So there you go. You guys and dolls have a delicious, delightful, delirious day. Read some books, go to the library, have a good time, and I'll see you tomorrow.